Hello, and in today's video, I am going to be covering the hardware connections that you need to program ATmega328P. Now, this is the chip that Arduino uses for their Uno chips. Let's see if it focuses. See, there's the chip's model number. Now, the first thing is, you see the divot at the top over here? That indicates the pin 1 for us. Okay, now I'm going to insert it into the breadboard. Now, the next piece of hardware we are going to need is a 10K resistor. And take over here. Then, 10K resistor, I'm going to measure out at about where I can insert it into the VCC line. Something I should probably cover. All my red lines are a common 5 volt line, like here. And then also, my blue lines are a common negative line. So the whole 5 volt rail runs through all the red lines on the entire breadboard. Okay, now that we have a measurement, we can take our resistor, trim it down. And so I'm going to repeatedly use this board with the effort to trim down the resistor. Sure it goes incorrectly. A tweezer resistance. It has to be difficult always. A nice neat resistor in place. Well, our reset line high. Now I'm going to add a button so that we can apply a manual reset if needs be. We quickly check that with the multimeter just to make sure I have it the correct way around. Okay, and continuity this way. None. And then when I press it, we have continuity. Okay. We take a wire on the other side of the button. We insert that. Actually, let's get a better wire. And we insert that on the opposite side. That will jump down to the negative. Actually, move that one up. So we have a neater the mirror. A neat wire. So now, actually, you know what? I forgot something. We need to actually jump our wire up. So get a nice jump wire, go from our pin 1, which is reset, wire that one in. We have a small jumper now here. When I press the button, I should get to 10 kilo ohms for random values. Okay, I'm going to assume it's jumping around because of contact bouncing, but why is this so loose? I'm going to replace this 10 ohm resistor because it weighs way too loose in the bugger the neatness. We want something that works properly. Okay, but I replaced the resistor now. The contacts were way too short. Then we have pin 7, which is VCC. So we check here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So at 25. We jump over to VCC, which is 5 volts, so the red rail. Then the following pin is going to be ground, which we also can just jump here. Let's say just after the VCC pin, we have our ground pin. And that goes into the ground rail or negative rail. And then the two pins after ground is going to be our oscillator. Which I'm going to take out of a packet here. And then the two pins next to it. Just insert the oscillator. I will check that closely. And you want those oscillator pins as close to your package pins. Then we take two 22 picofarad, a non-polarized capacitor. Then on each leg of the resonator, we just bridge that to ground so that we load the crystal so that it can start resonating and have a reference to ground. Since this is actually alternating current, so this the capsule scene is a short. And then we have a second ground, which is on pin 22. So we go all the way down here to pin, let me just double check, pin 14. And then we skip over. Then this one will be 15. Then we need 22. So 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So also on 25 of the breadboard. Hopefully you can see that. That will be ground. So we are placing it into the blue rail. And then two pins below the ground, we have AVCC, which is the supply for the analog to digital converter. Now, technically, you should have this through a low pulse filter, but I can't be bothered. If I have slightly inaccurate readings, it's not going to be the end of the world. Okay, so we insert that to VCC. You know what, since I have extra capacitors, take that one. We give it a negative across. So now I'm supplying and I am basically creating a semi-low pass filter, contradictory to my hypocritical statement earlier. Okay, so now we have all the basic stuff set up. Now what needs to be added is the programming lines. Okay, so now what I'm going to be using to program the device with is going to be a PIcket4. This is basically the universal programmer now from Microchip. So it can program anything from 80 tiny, 80 mega to 80 SAM, and then as well as the entire PIC range, including the PIC32s. So it's basically it's all in one solution for anything from Microchip. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to break out the programming pins for the ATmega328P to the PIcket4. Okay, so for the PIcket's header, first pin is going to be VTarget, so our VCC line. So we insert one line from VCC. The next one is going to be ground, so we just bridge from ground to the pin right next to it, if it stops being stubborn. And the next line from the PIcket is going to be meso, so pin 18 on the chip itself. So we go 15, 16, 17, 18. We bridge that one. And the one after that is going to be SCK, I believe. Yes, it's SCK. SCK is located on pin 19, so the one above meso. We take that and we do not insert it because I have a too short wire. Try another length of wire. If I cross, it's not the end of the world. If I can one day get one that's long enough. Okay. Probably too long. Yes. Long. Likely shorten it. And now it's probably going to be too short. And the one after that is going to be reset. From pin number one, we just route a wire. Round. And that wire is too long. Now we have our reset line in place, and then we have Mosey, which is pin 17. The last thing we do is we quickly just insert into the PIcket4 our 5 debug lines, if it is 5. So we skip pin 1, which is usually our M clear. Now I have to struggle to do this. There we go. Then line it. Pin 1, pin 2, pin 3, pin 4, and pin 5, and apparently I missed one, or I put in skew. Sorry if you can't see this. Yeah, I need to learn how to count apparently. We have plus one wire. And there we have a programming header now in. And we are going to hook a 330 ohm resistor to pin number 14. Just down here. And we're just going to attach a LED to that for when I start doing the blink test. Right. And that's the basic setup of setting up a ATmega328P for programming and development work. A like, share, comment, and subscribe would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.